We got power to everything. Make sure we're up and streaming. I haven't started the game yet. Mostly because I kind of want to. I want to give it a little bit of time. I'm gonna give it a little bit. Actually, I'm gonna go here. We're gonna throw the splash screen up for a second. Make sure everything's up and running. I was gonna sit here and talk to myself with the splash screen up. Hoping we get a couple people. Oh, come on. What are you doing? Why are you being difficult? Help me out. Hopefully we'll get some people. We'll get some. It's an awesome game we're gonna be playing tonight. Why are you being... Why does it always take so long? Let me finish this tweet. Oops, broke it. What am I doing? What happened? Alright, I think we got all those. Let's tweet that out. Hopefully we can get in here going. Alright, so... Get people a minute or two to kind of come in. We ran into a couple of problems tonight. We're hoping to have some of the developers that actually work on the game to come in with us. But as life is and as life happens... There were some emergencies, so they didn't quite make it tonight. I don't know why he does that. That makes no sense. Why aren't you showing me that I'm there? I'm so confused. I'm just sitting here talking to my little purple Yeti. We'll be right back. That shows that it's up and running. I don't understand. Do not understand. Why are you... There's Rivalry Gaming. Hey, man, what's going on? Hopefully you can hear me. Man, this thing's just being a... difficult. Alright, well, we're gonna go ahead and get started. We're gonna flip over. We'll show you my pretty face. Ready to go, Indie Monday. Alright, here's my pretty face. Alright, so I haven't started the game yet, mostly because there's some cool splash screens in here, and there's some things that I want people to see. So if they do go back and watch it, I want them to be able to see kind of what we're doing here. So let me get this thing started here. Alright, so let's go. That's all good. So let's play that. Uh-oh. That's not good. It worked a minute ago. We're gonna clear that. Hopefully that doesn't cause us problems. Alright, so this is the entry to this. So this is Dive Starpath. As you can kind of see there in the beginning of the intro there, this was made by EAE, which is the University of Utah, which is local here, has a program where they actually go in and they have guys, that's a whole computer class, or not computer class, but a whole college class about how to be a game developer. It's amazing. So the first thing I'm going to tell you about this game is made by a bunch of college students. Really, really great bunch of guys and gals, guys and gals. So Danny was supposed to be with us, which is the main art director of this project. She had an issue tonight, so she won't be able to join us. She's going to try to come in when she can. But it is what it is. Such is life, right? I hope everybody's okay and everything works out well for her. The main, the guys that do the programming stuff, he's leaving work late tonight. So he's going to try to get home and try to come in and hang out with us. So we're just going to kind of wing it. I've kind of visited with him quite a bit of time, so I know a good amount about the game. And we're just going to play. So the one thing I will tell you too is this game is planned to be free. So they're, unless they are completely forced to, they do not plan on charging for this game at any point in time. Oh no, they are definitely a hardworking team. So we're just gonna get on. So this is the graphics. This is what I saw in this game. The first time I saw this, I was at a Respawn Ready event, and I was like, dude. So the trick with this is I've seen this several times. The first time I saw this game, I was like, I have to have this on my computer. I have to be able to play this game. Who do I need to talk to be able to play this game? And I am playing with a controller. So it's just this is just my Logitech 710 wireless controller. So currently there's some bugs with, I think he said the Xbox One controller software or drivers. So I'm just flying around, so it shows you how to kind of get around. And then I can kind of rotate around here like this. And I promise you one thing, I will die a lot tonight. It will be amazing. There'll be a lot of death because there's rocks. And I'm not really super good at flying. So what I'm trying to do is fly through these things. And hopefully get enough oxygen. Because I think the oxygen powers my breathing. Oh, so I clipped the edge of the ring there. Hey, Jab Man, what's going on? So we're playing a new game tonight called Dive Starpath. Unfortunately, it won't let me put it in there because evidently the game doesn't exist for Twitch's reality. Oh, did it again. See, I told you I was gonna die a lot. All right. So I'm using the trigger buttons to basically rotate the screen around. I'm not sure what all the other stuff does. One of these days I should probably figure all that stuff out. But honestly, a lot of games like this, I like trying to come into here and not actually know what the hell I'm doing. Because it gives you a more honest reaction. So if I want to zoom out just a little bit. Can I zoom out? Is there a zoom out button? I don't know what the hell that did. I'm gonna figure it out here in a minute. But the one thing I did like about this game is you're flying around in space. It is a beautiful game. Definitely a little twitchy. I talked to the developers. They said that they definitely recommend using a controller to play. Holy crap. It is twitchy. No, it's the way I want it to go. I'm not flying right. I'm too busy talking. Getting all excited. But if y'all come here to watch somebody beat a game, then y'all come to the wrong channel. Holy cow, really? Alright, that was just ridiculous. But anyway, so I'm still stuck on the first level. We'll eventually get out of here. So the trick with this one, like I said, I kind of talked to one of the developers here a minute ago. He was kind of trying to kind of make sure I was okay before he took off for the day trying to get home. Holy crap. It just gets too close. I get claustrophobic. Hey, there he is. So we're trying to play. We're doing what we can here. So that's Garen. He's one of the developers. He's trying to get home. So I feel this pain. So we're going to kind of twitch our way through here, see if I can make it through the rocks. And I've been making it into the rocks. So you do see a lot of movement. Like I said, I try, especially in games like this, not to do a lot of pre-playing so that I'm bad. Can we do that? Is there a playing creative? Oh, we are. Oh. I like it. I did not realize I could do that. So let's throw a couple of hashtags on here. So we will do that. That is excellent. I like the way you think. Thanks a lot there, Rivalry. Alright, so let's resume this and resume my dying ways. So hey, Garen, is there a way I can zoom out? Or is this what I'm staring at? Yeah, I definitely am pulling out a little bit too soon. I think I'm trying to get set up for that next one. I'm not used to focusing so close to my screen. I'm used to focusing further out. Aha. I'm not going over there. Fell for that trick last time. It's a new record. I'm not sure what the green and the blue ones are, but I'm sure there's something important. Oh. It wouldn't go up there anymore. It stopped. It was going okay. Yeah, the triggers for the controller will actually rotate the screen around for you. So I have a 10%. I don't know what that is. I know the whole point here is I'm trying to collect stuff because I'm trying to find out what happened and what's going on. And I'm trying to get back to my ship. It's the bits of the story that I did get. So I tried to get a little bit of the story. So I don't know. Okay, so that bar is going down rather rapidly. And I was watching the bar. So this game is called Dive Starpath. So it is a pre-release, I guess, is the best way to describe it. So there's a program, and we'll be talking about this all night. So it's University of Utah. So I live in the state of Utah in the United States. And the University of Utah has a program that basically teaches game development. And part of the game development that they teach is kind of how to get your game built, made, and basically get it in the hands of people. Because a lot of good a game is going to do if you can't actually freaking develop it. So what good is a game developer if they've never developed a game? So basically what the program does is it teaches the students basically how to develop a game. And I probably need to be flying around a lot more instead of talking so much. But actually get it developed. So eventually this game will be on Steam. Currently it is only on Windows right now. That hit like a mark or something. So this game will eventually be on Steam. It's going to be on anywhere that they can put it. They're going to basically their goal is not to make money from this game. this is basically a resume for them. So everywhere that they can put this game, it will be free. And that's what the information I just got from Garen. So basically, as soon as it comes out, you'll be able to play the game. So what we're trying to do today... Oh my lord, I cut close again. See, stick rotation, green score, blue equals life. I agree with you, and that's a rock. One thing, I don't know if this thing... It's an amazing looking game. I don't know about it for streaming, because every time I look over the chat, I die. Plumier Plumber? What? Are you kidding me? You can call me Plum. You can call me Yeti. Yeah, I think you are right. I think the green is definitely... Ah! I don't know if I got him or not. And that's cool that they kind of set it up so that you can go for the score, but then... If you go for the score, then you're basically killing yourself. So you have to kind of balance it out and choose which direction you want to go. Woo! Oh, that was a rock! Alright, let's see. Losing connection! Hey, did you get my Skype? If I did, I didn't see it. So... What about my schedule, Jab? We already answered that stuff. I didn't see it, man. I have to look at it in a little bit and see if I can. Ooh, I guess we got a couple of points. At least it's a fast-paced game, and it is definitely a beautiful game. So I do like I have Elite Dangerous. I have a couple other games, and just the stars and the way. Oh my lord, I cut it quick again. I have Brother Under Monday. What? I'll have to look and see what the heck. I may have typed it in. I was doing that before I went to work this morning, so. Trying to update my schedule so it made a little bit more sense to people. Or at least reflect what I was doing. Ooh. I'm picking up the things. No. There's got to be a way to, like, speed up and slow down. Because I remember they said that. Push buttons and see what happens. That did something. Nope, turn that off. Whoa, that really did something. So, and you do have a jetpack, so you can speed up. So, if I want to go here, go a little bit faster. Like, I can do that. But it actually uses your oxygen, too. So, you have to be careful. What the heck's going on? Twitch just quit life on you. Twitch is twitchy, man. Like, I can't even get my Amazon Fire to connect tonight for some reason. I don't know why. That's weird. But Twitch has been getting weird and weirder lately. They're kicking off game devs that are developing their own game. I don't know what the hell they're doing. Is it just me or does it seem like it's going faster now? Perspective. Hey, thanks for sharing. Thanks for helping, buddy. Oh. Oh, nice. Hot drink, it committed Twitch aside. Hell yeah. Twitch is just, I don't know. Twitch is, and it sucks, right? Because the whole ultimate idea is to do it. So it'd be great to go out and like stream and go do all these other crazy stuff and like start streaming on other channels too. What the hell was that? Oh, you're gonna have to wait, buddy. But oh, and then I know eventually later in the game these things will start flipping around. So once again, Unkbot to the rescue. So Unkbot's basically throwing up the Facebook page for these guys, and also throwing up their actual website. So if you can go to those things, if you want to get more information from the developers, they're also on Twitter. So they are at, I think, if you follow me on Twitter, I've been tweeting them out all day. But it's, I think it's at Dive Starpath. So you can kind of join, meet up with them. If you do have questions for them, want to know more about the game, please feel free, tweet at them. Go tell them that you saw me, and you know, hopefully. We'll get more and more of the games from this program. If we can get more of the games from the program, then we get more indie games. We get more cool things to look at that other people don't get to see. That's what I'm trying to do here. Is I'm trying to bring you guys games that maybe you can't go to another channel to find, right? Because as much fun as it would be to, sometimes it's just about seeing something new, seeing something different. And whether you like it or not, it's about, you know, just being something a little bit different. Keep going. We still need more to compile the data. I'm going to compile your data. Awesome. Now I'm gonna die again. Yep. So that's what happens when you run out of oxygen. You can't move around anymore. Speaking at Indie Night, time to hit the pool later on. Nice. No, Indie Night's cool, man. Like I want to be able to do that. Like I love seeing different games, and like this is definitely one of those cool games that, you know, whether it's kicking your butt or not, it's still gorgeous. But yeah, so please go follow him on Facebook, follow him on Twitter. If you want more information about the game, when it's going to come out, stuff like that. Then we may have, I have a surprise too. So I was talking to Garen here a minute ago. This game is on Windows 10. So it is, you can go get it right now. So we have that information for you. We can get you the game. But the problem is you have to be on Windows 10 and you have to be playing on a computer. So no ultrabooks or anything crazy like that, because it is 3D. Basically it needs a video card, right? And unfortunately ultrabooks don't usually have video cards. I think I'm just slightly missing some of these barrels, and I think that's not helping me out. Maybe I need to start trying to run them right across my back. Oh, that seems to be doing better. Oh, until I got a rock in the face! So, but yeah, no. So this is out on Windows 10. You can actually go get it right now and download it and play it. So I have a link for you guys here in a little bit. I will definitely share that. So, and then y'all can go play the game and kind of get back to the developers, let them know what you think, let you know. And like I said, they're just doing this as a school project, basically. They're trying to build their resume up so that they can go, you know, be game developers and continue doing what they love. So, and that's just the dream, right? It's whether, you know, matter, oop, I almost got it. Whatever it is, you want to be able to do, you know, the dream. And a lot of the guys that come in here, Trank, myself, you know, DJ, we all have dreams, right? And we're trying to follow those dreams where we, I just can't get over there. Can I get better if I spin and pull up? Yeah, thanks for sharing. I appreciate your help. You're awesome. So, like I said, hopefully we'll get a little bit further in here tonight. Hopefully I'll start getting a little bit better here, figure this dang control system out, and not run into rocks! So hopefully we can eventually get past this, because there is like a couple of more levels. So they do have more levels, as opposed to the one I keep trying to show you guys. So what do you guys think so far? Do you think this is a cool idea? Do you think it's other than me getting myself killed repeatedly and making a mockery of myself? Oh! I keep hitting asteroids and looking over and seeing Trank's comment. It's not boosting my self-confidence, Trank. You're not helping, Trank. Pretty sure those yellow things show me. I don't know what those yellow things are showing me. Actually, I'm not sure exactly what those yellow things are. Yeah, the controls. I'm having, and it may just be me, because I don't normally play these games. So may not be doing it super good justice. And then like I'm not really smooth on the controller. I'm kind of flicking it. I'm used to playing like more shooters and things like that, right? I'm used to playing Grand Theft Auto and things like that in car games where you kind of flick the control for those. So unfortunately I'm kind of doing that here, and it may be leading to my detriment. So I'm sure there's some trick about lining them up so that you can go through a little bit easier and stuff like that, that I am not freaking following. You're not finished yet. Keep going. Thanks for helping. You're great. Woo! Oh! Oh! That was so close. Does suck that I have to start over. Come on, give me a save gate or something. Of course, that doesn't help. This is gonna get boring. But we'll get it. One thing I am, I'm determined. That's for sure. I don't know how to force it to get. There's got to be a way to do it. All right. Yeah, see, I'm just missing them. Received, Juno. Keep going. We still need more to compile the data. What? I grabbed green ones and it didn't. Oh, come on. Okay, I already played this part. Okay, it's not going from 95. That's not cool, yo. Did I break it? Oh, look. What's this guy? I found the ship! Yeah, that's definitely one thing. I think they need to kind of push the HUD out just a little bit. It makes me feel a bit claustrophobic. I think if they pushed out just a little bit, I think it may help or give people the option.
It's been far too long since I began the journey to the star system, and I'm beginning to think there's not much out there. Hopefully, this log will keep my head on straight and give me a way back.
Woo! Did I not update that? Make sure I updated it just to make sure. Oh, look, another one! Oh, great, big movie things. This should help. Oh. Oh, this doesn't look like a good place to fly. Why would you fly through the big air turbines? Oh, what the hell? Somebody hates me! Oh, clipped it. All right. I promise I'll try to answer you guys' questions if you'll have them. Say, hear my tongue out. Oh, I missed all of those. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know if it's just like if it pulls up faster. Me some oxygens. Oh, that's my friend again. I'm gonna salvage. You're really old in a minute. Oh, come on. Oh, I caught it back up. All right, good. It's a big, big jet engine. Whoa. Thanks for the help. Oh! Really? Yeah, the hitbox for the... for the to pick things up is pretty unforgiving. I got them turned down too. I can turn them up too, if y'all want to. If y'all hear them, the music's actually really cool. It's the one thing, the art and the music is definitely cool. I mean, I know. Take a couple of chances, see if I can speed this thing up. Oop. I'll re-enter you in a minute. Why is it always with computers and machines taunting me? First portal, now these guys. That Arthur guy, man, he's always taunting me. Whoa, that doesn't look cool. How do I slow down? I was trying to get it. Man, that Arthur guy's always taunt me. She just keeps repeating stuff. I'm like, I already heard this story. Oh, see? Oxygen. Oh, I don't know how I survived that one. Oh, I'm not going in there. It was not lined up well.
Keep going. We still need more to compile the data.
Oh! Out of nowhere. Probably should start using that speedy up thing. I just don't like using it because I'm already so limited on oxygen, and I tend to burn through it really fast. Oh, that's what I get for being greedy.
Hey, this salvage looks really old. It could be re-entry equipment from a massive ship.
Come on, grab him. Oh! Yeah, I think the hitbox is high. It's what it seems like to me, anyway. Because, like, I can run, like, through the... If I go down, it seems like I'm fine. If I pull up too soon, I get freaking wrecked. Oh! Because I've actually put my feet through stuff on the bottom a couple of times. Yep, see, and I get a little bit too close to the top and wrecked.
Hey, this salvage,
it's my story, I'm sticking to it. I'm going around that thing. I'm tired of messing with it. That may have been a bad mistake. Yep. Whee! Welcome to Plum Yeti Fells a Lot. Really? Just tap it with my foot. All right, that's getting ridiculous. Nope, not quite fast enough. So way to speed up. What the heck's going on with that? I don't understand what that does. Except for... So let me cut faster? Whoa! I didn't think I was that close to that one that time. Where's the replay? Instant replay! Watch the instant replay. I don't know. I missed it. I'm not sure what this does. Thanks for helping. Oh, I'm out of gas. I will say they burn gas quick. I don't understand what that key does. It like kills my other boosters or something. I'm so confused.
These black boxes are a trail. Ellis, have you
Yeah, so I just went through that one. Figure out how I did that. I can reproduce it. Oh yeah, I'm dead again. Really? Ah. I was going to say time to get serious. Evidently not. Do, 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 do. Stop for a minute. Options. Yeah, I don't think inverting any of that will be helpful. Let's see, help. Alright, let's see what this does. Boost back. What's, oh, back. Rotate, navigate, boost. It doesn't actually do much. It just makes a boing sound at me. There's no back. All right. Oh. All right. I want to get through it. Not like that, I'm not. Very unforgiving. Definitely unforgiving. Yeah, see? You just get out and, I don't know, maybe if I spin upside down I can pull up faster or something. So I don't know. I don't know if I'm supposed to spin around, if I pull up faster. Doesn't seem to pull up faster. Thanks. Oh.
Hey, this is salvage. That's really awful.
You're not helping. Yeah, see, like, once you get out of position, you're just kind of hosed. Nope. Oh. At least it makes a fun sound when you knock your brains out. Actually, we'll go back here in a minute. We're going to turn these things. We're going to turn the sound effects back up a little bit. That way you guys can kind of listen to the music, and the music score in here is really good. The sound effects are definitely interesting. Other than me being horrible at it, it's a fun game. Oh, just so close again. Problem is you're already moving at a pretty good speed. I'm feeling panicked. Yeah, see, I just can't get over there once I'm out of position. You have to talk to him. Wonder if... That would actually could work. Look at you glitching out. I have to talk to him. Maybe, we'll have to see if... So I don't know if this is, like, just the difficulty, if this is just the game. But it may be worth it. So I think the speed, you're trying to get used to the game, trying to get used to it. And the speed is definitely something that's kind of makes you feel panicky. So I wonder if they could go with like a couple of different difficulty levels and maybe do something with the speed. Just to kind of give you the idea, so that way you can kind of play through multiple times. Or at least give you a reason to play through multiple times. Yeah, see, I'm afraid I'm gonna smack it. Oh, right into the fence, or into the engine again. We're gonna keep going. Oh, holy Lord. I love those ones when I start out the thing and just wham! Yeah, see, like, almost, I don't know if I gotta be doing something wrong or something, because I can't make that curve. I can't make the curve that it shows you to make. I don't know if I got something wrong, if I'm not, like, spinning correctly, like, if you can dive faster than you can. You can rise or something, or if I'm just not ballsy enough to go for it. Yeah. But some of that has to do with like we're saying, the HUD is definitely kind of in your face. Yeah, see, I can't get down there. Oh, wow. I suck! Hey, Gary, man, what's going on? Well, you've missed a couple of thousand of my deaths. Which seems to be a common occurrence with these games like this. But, you know, I'm fine with dying a little bit. Whoa. Try that again. Whoa. Whoa. So, I was just talking. Can you, like, pull up faster than you can sink or something, or am I supposed to be using the spinning around feature more often? Because I noticed there's some curves that I just can't make. No matter pretty much what I do, I'm just hosed. Oh, I'm out of gas again. I was doing so well. Boost directly as you turn. Oh, or just kiss a rock. Yeah, we can do that. I'll call you back real quick. Get back in here. Whoa! Nope, and into a rock again. Oh, Skype's doing something? Nope, Skype's thinking. I lost all sound because Skype is evil. Whoa! Yeah, then I use all my gas and I can't move anymore. Yeah, okay, so that does work a little bit, but then I use all my gas. At least the computer's not helping me anymore. Until Skype figures out it and hangs up. Then we'll come back. There it goes. Pretty sure it hates me. Oh, there it goes. So the other thing we were noticing too is that it seems the hitbox is a little high. I don't know if it's just my imagination or if I'm just crazy. It's possible I'm crazy. But it seems like if I fly like headlong into them, sometimes I miss them. But if I fly just below them, it seems to do a lot better. Then I'm out of... No, what the hell's going on here? No, what the hell... Oh, I ran out of gas. Yeah, Skype is being derpy or something. I don't know what the heck's going on over here. It is not being helpful, that's for sure. Yeah, I know, and then the... Don't mind me. No, I love it. It's an amazing game. It's just the oh, see? It's times like you think you're clear, not so much. So is this just the playthrough speed, the difficulty, or are y'all gonna have multiple difficulties for this? Oh, I see that didn't work out well. Burned all my gas and I didn't get them. Oh, what are these yellow things? I have so many questions. I'm at 40. Yeah, I'm gonna die. Oh. It was part of the gravity mechanic. He decided to scrap it last moment. Oh, okay. Whoa. Woo! So the other thing we were noticing is the, I'm feeling a little claustrophobic. With the HUD is very close. The, in the body. It blocks your screen. I don't know if that's kind of what y'all meant for it to do. And the body being there, I don't know, it just, to me it feels really claustrophobic. But no, I love the game. I love the assets. I definitely think y'all are onto something. Or, you know, I've been after Danny for months trying to get me a copy of this game. No. All right, cool. No worries, man. Yeah, I know this is definitely early. You guys are still working on it, but at the same time, I want to give honest feedback and definitely let y'all know what I'm thinking. Things to make it more fun. So the other thing I was thinking, so I don't know if y'all ever thought about it or not, but maybe give difficulties where you go different speeds or something, so that you can kind of like start at a slower speed. Because the speed for this, especially somebody that's not used to playing games like this, is a bit. Take feedback from a much wider audience now, so that will be the game release in the summer. Yeah. No. That's cool, man. Like I said, that's the big thing. And like I said, we got the card or the code, so that here later in the stream we're gonna I'll throw that in the chat, and then if people want to have access, it's definitely early access. I don't want to go that way. It's definitely early access, but if you're on Windows 10, you know, we'll hook you up, and you know, Gary was nice enough to give me the link so that we can get people in and basically get feedback to them and make this a much better game. So if that's something that you're interested in, We'll definitely get you that information. So, and then like I said, Garen is one of the developers. So if you guys have questions for him or whatever, or you want to know more about this, that, or three, the other, he is probably one of the guys that you definitely want to talk to. Sorry, trying to concentrate. It's very hard to concentrate and talk because that happens. Like how I'm blaming my suckiness on talking. No really, I promise. I'm really good at video games. I never said I was good at video games. I just said I like playing them. And honestly, I'm not doing very good at this one, but I'm having fun playing it. So. Definitely gives you that oh, I gotta beat this. I can do it. This part here is kind of fun. Till it punches you in the face. Feels a little panicky. At 70%. Don't fail me now. Oh, I missed it. Oh, am I out of gas? No. I'm trying. I'm failing miserably. I'm getting too panicky. I think the part of the problem is I tried to get it's hard to see, but what happens is I'm trying to get it lined up with more of my head. And then I remember at the last second that I needed to basically try to... I'm trying to run it through the two packs on her back. And then, yeah, see, I just phased right through that thing. So then I remember to do that, and then by the time I do that, then I get, it throws me out of position, and then I'm hosed. Yeah, see, and then that guy's, I always forget and don't go over there, and then I have this whole thing here where I have no energy. And then I die. Yeah, so, and then I get, oh look, a ring, and then I'm gone. I'm gonna die now. Oh, come on, for the love of Pete. I don't know who Pete is. That's great. I appreciate your help. Oh! So close, yet so far away. Yeah, so I will say that, like, yeah, so once I get out of position, it's so hard to see that path because unless you just remember where it is, it's almost impossible to get back on it. But that, like you said, that's part of your UI, that's part of your HUD fixes. Glad I can help. Oh, yeah, she did it again. Oh! But yeah, so as the bot's helping out there, make sure you guys, if you do want more information, please go check out their Facebook. Go check out their website. The links are there in the chat. And also... they are on Twitter, if you prefer to use Twitter. They're just at Dive Starpath. So if these are guys that you're interested in, or if this is a game that you're interested in and you want to follow the development, please go follow them. Like I said, they're really, really good people. I've met them a couple of times at different events that I've gone to here in Utah. So they're local Utah developers attending the University of Utah and the EAE program. So if you are definitely somebody that is interested in either developing or looking at a game or trying to get in touch with game developers, these are definitely people to talk to. And the EAE program, everything that I've seen from it so far is just an amazing program itself. Quite honestly, I'm looking at it probably for my daughter to go to. So, I just phased through another one. But no. So, and then, like I said, this is a game that's basically made in a program. We're going to go this way this time. Oh, I'll mess up your ship in a minute. We're at 45, that means I'm gonna die soon. That seems to be. See? Told you. I called it. But no, it's. And then there's many other many other games. So there's. I think there's like 10 games that they're releasing this year or something on different platforms. They just do amazing stuff out there. And then, like I said, this is one of those games coming out of the EAE program. It is awesome. It's hard. It definitely has beating the crap out of me tonight. That's what it's doing. I will get it. I will beat it eventually. I'll be good at it one of these days. Or I'll just go cry. I'm not gonna cry. Maybe I might cry. So I do like this part. I kind of feel accomplished when I get through it. Or I just die like that. But that's actually a cool mechanic. I like those. The rocks are cool too, but like I said, the path is kind of hard. I don't know if it's just me or what it is, but like that, like there's, like I just feel like I know I can use that boost function, but seeing as how it basically chews my life away, I don't like to. Yeah, see, I'm not getting up there. Yeah, right in the face. Yeah, no, that's fine. I know she had some stuff that came up. So life happens, man. It's, what are you gonna do? I'm not one to complain. Like hell, I had to take almost, I think it was a month and a half off from streaming, because I had an elbow injury. So I'm just now starting to get back from that. I'm actually not wearing my brace for the first time streaming in a couple of weeks, just because my elbow is actually starting to feel a little bit better. So, but yeah, no, you gotta contend with life, right? So hopefully everybody's okay and everybody's doing okay. So that's the most important part. Oh, I missed it.
You're not finished yet. Keep going.
Hey, thanks for reminding me.
Hey, this salvage looks really old. It could be re-engine equipment
for a massive ship. I'm trying to do my best to keep up with the chat over there, but it's, oh, that thing's turning around the wrong way. It made me sad. Do. It's my favorite part to die in again.
We still need more to compile the data.
Oh, see, told you. No, yeah, no worries, man. Like, I think there's a little things that we could do. I'm not developing in this. I'm just playing it. Poorly, I might add. But the I think especially for the beginning of it, I think the first little bit, slow it down just a hair. And then you can speed it back up in the later levels, or just give us a difficulty that controls the speed. Because I think if I went a little bit slower, I wouldn't feel like, I feel like I had an idea and I could kind of play it. And I wouldn't, it'd make it a little bit easier, I think. And then, or just have it ramp up. So you're like, oh yeah, so you beat it on the slow settings. Good for you. Now we're going to speed it up, sucka. And then you can be like, oh, now I got to beat it on the fast settings. And then that would give you a kind of a chance to kind of learn the path. Right, so that way, you know, it'll kind of help you learn the path and learn how where you need it to go to do these things. So I think that may help too. Oopsie, phase through that one. I wish I knew how I did that. I would do it more often. So see, yeah, no, you're not. No, don't turn around. Turn around. Come back for me. I want the green. Oh. Oh, I failed again. There's a lot of fail. Can I just cut these up and just like cut all the deaths out? And then just make it look like I just flew through here for like hours on end. Be like, I'm perfect. Look at me. I made it through all these things. Don't mind the cuts. I want to go in there. This one's green. But there's no blue in here, so I'm going to probably die. I will get it. I beat the first level. Sometimes that's all you can do. Come on. Nope. Oh, no, I'm not out of gas. What's going on here? Going on over there. I can't read it though. Take my eyes off the screen. I die. I keep my eyes on the screen. I die. I die. That's all I do. I just die. I don't know how I hit that. Oh, that died. I ran out of gas. All right, let's see. Oh, hey there. So it looks like Danny actually made it in with us. Dark Souls space. Yeah, that's pretty much the feeling I'm getting. There needs to be more rolling. More rolling. So Danny, Garen's in here with us too. Is my controller being wonky? I'm gonna blame it on my controller. No, go up, go up. Nope, fail. Reading over, looking at stuff. Oh no, now my controller really is being wonky. Really? My battery's dying again? I think my daughter stole my controller again. Okay. Something's going on because I'm getting input lag. Yeah. Really? What's going on here? Okay, we seem to be okay. Don't get me wrong, I'll freely admit that I can't play games, but input lag's not helping. Yeah, so I'm squeezing. Oh man, I think I'm gonna have to get another controller. This thing does this every once in a while. I think I'm just gonna break down and just buy a wired controller. Wireless is fun until it starts doing wonky stuff. Don't worry, I wasn't doing any better when it wasn't doing wonky stuff. It's just now it is. Oh no, now it seems to be doing alright. That means I'm just gonna die and it'll be my fault. Yeah, that seems to be fine. That was weird. Oh! No, yeah, we were just talking with Garen about some of the different stuff. Had a couple of issues, a couple of things to feedback. Hopefully, but no, so far it looks amazing, and I'm definitely, it is a beautiful game, as always. So, and Danny, you're the art director, right? Whoa. Whoa. Waiting for that Twitch lag to catch up. I know I'm not finished. I haven't been finished for an hour. Thanks for reminding me. Oh. Really? Now you're doing it again. Yeah, no, really? No, you're doing... What the heck's going on with this thing? Nice. So yeah, so the art and all that's... Okay, now my controller's just being hard to get along with. Really? I don't... Alright, that's it. Give me a second. I'm gonna go grab a couple of batteries. See if I can get this thing to work better. Alright, let's try this again. Now, for some reason, when this thing, the battery starts getting low, it, like, the inputs hang. And it's just like, oh, you wanted to go left? Well, we'll just keep going left. And sometimes, in some games that I play, it's not that big of a deal. This one is, it's a bit of a deal. Okay, that's better. My batteries were dying. Oh, face to another one. Alright, what?
Keep going. We still need more to compile the data.
Nope, we ain't compiling nothing. Hi, Art Director, I'm Trink. And Trink is definitely a fell fish. He is. Trink is actually very, very good at just breaking games just outright. I was nowhere near that thing. All right, I'm watching instant replay. Is that smoking crack? What the hell happened there? Yeah, I was nowhere near it. I saw that. I was nowhere near that guy. I was dead center of it. It was just like, nope. Denied. Freaking, this is Dark Souls in space. They put code in. They have a kill switch. Just to make it more interesting. They're just giggling and laughing and pushing the button that just causes me to self-destruct. It's my story. I'm sticking to it. I never break stuff. Nah, Trink's a good guy. Yeah, that's not gonna work out for me well.
They're not finished yet.
Thanks. I'm out of juice again. I never break stuff. So no, it is a good game. Like I said, it is still definitely early access. If y'all do want access to it, what time are we? We're 9:30. So we will throw this in here. So this only works if you are on Windows 10. You have to be on Windows 10 for this to work. Let's see, what was the code? Damn it. Why did I need to put in here? Yeah, that's it. Thank you. So there's that. So you can click on that link. That will give you early access. It only works on Windows 10, and you have to be on a PC. So if you're interested in wanting to play it, feel free, go grab it. Talked to Garen earlier, and he said I could give you all the access code there. So you have to be on Windows 10. You have to be on a PC for it to work, because it is 3D accelerated. So you will need basically a 3D accelerator for it to function. But then they highly recommend that you use a gamepad on it. I would challenge you to go be better than I was, but that won't be much of a difficult task. If you can't beat me on this game, then I feel sorry for you. Because I suck. But I have fun. That's really all that matters. I'm still having a good time. I just get too caught up and go, oh, look pretty, and then squish. Are my controllers being wonky?
Keep going. We still need more to compile the data.
Nope. I don't want to compile the data.
The data
seems pretty compiled to me. Somebody's saying something, I can't read it. I'm at 70. I'm gonna die soon. Oh, I told you. Yeah, it's definitely an intense learning curve. That's I was talking earlier, and it may be worth it to put in difficulty levels. Obviously, it's your game. Please do what you want. I will just sit here and ramble. But maybe difficulty levels. So as you play, it starts out slower, because I think if you give it a little bit slower speed, so that you can kind of grasp what's going on instead of being reactionary, because I am definitely being reactionary. So I have no idea what I'm doing. I'm just trying to go through the rings. And then you can kind of learn the path. And there I went. I phased through a ring again. It's just my favorite thing to do. And then as you beat the game or whatever, the difficulties can ramp up. Things can move faster. Ate it. But that may help a little bit with the learning curve. The other thing that is kind of hard to balance up, because if my skydiver here touches something and I die, pulling the camera too far back from her may cause trouble with perspective. So that one may be harder to do. And I actually, now that I've played it a little bit more and I'm kind of getting used to it, it's not as bad. I'm getting a little bit more comfortable with the controls. That being said, of course, I'll die instantly here in a second. I know I'm not finished yet. I haven't seen the little shippy thing that I get to go in and be happy because I beat the level. Sometimes you just have to try to go for it. I'm just sad because I can't show you guys more of the levels. It'd be nice for me to be able to go through and do that, but I suck, so we'll just keep playing this one. Starting to get the hang of it though. I say as I explode into a million pieces. Oh. And then the other thing too. Give me a checkpoint. Because obviously I could be imagining it, but it seems like as you go around, you're basically going around a track. So as I fly around, because obviously I fly through this thing, and then my favorite part down here with the spinny ringy things. Give us a checkpoint, maybe. So as you complete a lap, it kind of saves your progress. And then on the really, that could give you another difficulty one too. Where you'd be like, okay, well you're on the max difficulty now. There is no more checkpoints, sucka. But so, and just ideas. So, oh. Oh, we'll try here real quick. Nope, I pressed it. It didn't do anything. Oh, and...
I have to...
Aha! Continue! Let's do that! I got cheats! See? And this is why you bring the developers into the stream with you. Get wrecked, game! Approaching Zora. Which means I'm probably going to jump to the end and it's just going to murder me instantly. It's just going to laugh at me. Whoa! That one was getting all grabby. Whoa, what the hell? Oh! I don't blame you. This one's amazing looking. I'm not sure I like the doors, but... Oh, I got owned again. Alright, fine, I'll go this way. No, I'm not going that way. I was thinking about going that way. Game had different plans. A meteor shower? I don't like the sounds of that. I don't like. Oh, the doors are not friendly. The doors are not friendly at all. They tried to close on you. I probably have to use the faster thingy, like this. Woo! All right, that was scary. I didn't like it. Did not like it at all. Oh, get off me! Can't we all just get along? Why can't we be friends? Oh, this doesn't look nice. Well, it looks nice, but it doesn't look nice. Well, at the rock. And I ran out of power. I ran out of oxygens. That didn't work out the way I wanted it to. I got all scared. Ha! I went through a door. I do like this, though. This is just such a cool visual. Oh! Until I do that. It's possible. Like, some of it, like, this is still early access. So I have phased through a couple of things. So there's some collision mod models that still need some work. So that's fine. You know, don't get me wrong. Like, I love seeing early access. I love seeing stuff that we can't normally see. Like I said, I've been fortunate enough. I've seen this specific game at two events. No, I've seen this game at three different events so far. Because it was actually at the somebody was playing it at the Uden event that I went to, which was cool. So I've been very fortunate, and every time I see it, they've done more and more work on it. So they're actively working on it, which is something we definitely look for in an indie developer. Somebody is actively working on their game, because sometimes they don't. So whenever you get a developer that actually cares about the game and is actually trying to put a good product out there, to me that's worthy of you know, of attention. And I want those. That looks like a bunch of them. I don't know if that was a good direction to go or not, but I went there. And I'm out of gas. I picked up 5. Why was I out of gas? Yeah, I noticed that when you do boost, it kind of goes all blurry on you.
Juno, I'm detecting a meteor shower and pick up the data quickly.
Yep, phase through it.
I'll see you past the debris.
Whee! Yep, right through the door. Oh, didn't go through that one. They were saying earlier that they did. Oh, now you're doing it again. The hell are you doing, you silly controller? They said that the keyboard controls are not very good. Yeah, see? So it's not my battery. What the hell's going on with this controller? Those are brand new batteries, jerk face controller.
Pick up the data. Understood. I'll see you past the debris.
So there's it. Oh. Right into the rock. So can I use a flight stick?
Juno, I'm detecting a meteor shower imprint. Pick up the data quickly. Understood. I'll see you past the debris.
Yeah, so you can boost straight through the doors, so that's good. Unless the doors don't stop you at all. Nope, they stop you. So evidently you can boost through doors, you just can't fly through them. So that's good to know.
Juno, I'm detecting a meteor shower imprint.
I know! I've been hearing about this meteor shower for a while. Yeah, I have a decent flight stick. I probably could set it up so I could do it. Because that would be a lot more intuitive, because I use that for a lead. So I'd probably be. Nope. Yeah. See, I didn't boost, but I have my flight stick. I don't know if you guys can see it. It's kind of the cable's kind of hidden. But I have a Cytec X55 Warthog or whatever it is. So that would give this game a little bit more life. Then I wouldn't be able to blame my controller. Yeah, I probably should have bought one of the cheap $20 ones from GameStop, but I was silly and bought the $50 frickin' wireless one, and it frickin' freaks out on me every once in a while. Right. So I have this bad boy. So it's the Logitech G710, I think it is. So it's a good controller until it freaking hangs every once in a while. I don't know why it does it. I've had it for a while, so it might just be getting old. Yeah. Oh, come on. Now I'm out of gas again. I'm gonna die now. I should have went the other way. Ah, we're all Temple of Doom in it. I know about this meteor shower. Oh, I was trying to sneak over there to get gas and didn't make it. Now I've done it. But yeah, so like I said, this is Dive Starpath. It's put on by some of the wonderful people in the chat right now. If this is something you are interested in and you want to know more about, my bot should be throwing stuff up there every once in a while. They are on Facebook, they are on Twitter. You can go to gravitywellstudios.com, and that's their webpage. But yeah, go give them a shout out on Twitter. Go holler at them. They're really good about replying and stuff. So really, really awesome group of people. I keep saying guys, and they're not all guys. So I try to, and definitely in this day and age, you know, there's a lot of women that decide to kind of follow this path, and that's awesome. And I actually really, really admire it, mostly because I have a daughter and she wants to follow this path. So I think that's cool. But yeah, so the artwork, which is kind of hard for me to concentrate on as I'm flying. Oh, I haven't been here in a little while. Keep getting murdered. I get murdered. Oh, there you are. The bot's right on it. So there's their Facebook. There's their web pages. Please go check them out. Go look at it. They got some videos. They got some good stuff on there. Go give them a shout out. Let them know what you thought. Go tell your friends about it. And then kind of keep a lookout for them. And definitely watch for the game to come out on Steam. And nope, didn't make it through that time. So they were saying earlier the yellow moon shape is something to do with the gravity mechanic. So there was I'm not sure what the gravity mechanic was, but they scrapped it. And they didn't. The yellow moons are still there. At least that's my understanding. I could be wrong. Oh, I hit a rock. We can go too far to the planet? Oh, you do. It gets excited and you die if you go over there. So if those get too bright, you die. That's what happens. As demonstrated by the Yeti. Because I've died all the other ways, I figured why not try that way too. Oh, nice. Yeah, welcome to the channel, man. The Last Ginger. Look at you with an awesome name. Well, I don't know how much gameplay you're going to see. You're going to see a lot of game fail. Because I'm not really, really too good at playing it. I'm getting a little bit better. Yep, see? Yeah, I say that and then I die. There goes my theory. The other side catches me on fire? Oh, it does! Look at me, I'm on fire! Damn gamers, tell them something will happen bad to them, and what do? They go set themselves on fire. Look, Ma, no hands! Whoa. Oh, I thought I was going to get through there. Pick up the data quickly. Stop throwing rocks in my way. Doors aren't helping either. Doors are not helping. I'm out of gas. Oh no. Yeah, I tested that because I was doing it for a while. But it failed. It failed very badly. There are sometimes, no matter what you do, you're eating a door. Come on this way this time. Nope, I'm not going that way this time. I'm going fill boat direction, that's what I'm doing. Let me see, dude, can we get through another one? We can. Alright, let's go look at another one.
Nothing but empty space.
There was a lot of fill boat there.
I hope I can make it before the ship runs out of power.
So we got a little bit more time, so try to see if we can get a couple more levels, kind of let people see what different levels look like. I know they spent quite a bit of time on the art and trying to get the different levels to look different. That's a big door. I don't know how I got out of that, but all right, cool. Well, alrighty then. I'm gonna go through the middle, see how that works out for me. Not well. That is cool looking, though.
There's too much debris. If Ellis made it this far...
Yes, Danny is the art director. Pick up rings ahead. And she is definitely a female. Whoa, that is cool, though. Who came up with this design? Oh, this is cool right here. I like this. It's like a big space slinky with doors in it.
There's too much debris. If Ellis made it this far, it had to be by a different route. Do you pick up rings ahead? Confirmed. But Juno, then we keep going.
Oh, I'm gonna die. Nope, maybe not. I'm gonna die now. How did I live through that? I'm special. It's like giant space slinkies. It is a cool effect, though. I don't even think I can handle this in VR, though.
Keep going.
Murder some people. Okay. Hey, look, it's the beginning again. And my favorite part. Holy crap, I got to 100%. How'd that happen? Oh, because I died. Whoa. Woo. Oh. Nice. Oh! Hey, yeah, that worked. No, I think the female character's kind of cool, too. At first, I was kind of like, whoa, okay, I don't know about flying through there. That's kind of freaky. Okay, that's not the best way to tackle that part.
Debris. If Ellis made it this far, it had to be by a different route.
need more green things.
There's too much debris. If Ellis made it this far, it had to be by a different route. Do you pick up readings ahead?
Oh, I died again. Gonna wake up. I wake up every day with a headache. Alright, let's go to another one. How many more levels do I have? Because I'm gonna try to get through, at least to let people see some of the levels as we play through.
Trinkets for a little girl who probably has no memories of a father. Having this so-called map to a home I've never seen. It's a strange feeling. My family has surely changed as a vibe.
It can be. Nice. Yeah, no, that's definitely a cool. I love the art in here. It's okay. Okay, that's kind of freaky. That definitely optical illusions you into thinking that you're okay when you're really not. Oh, what the hell. Alright, I'm not sure I like the slinkies anymore. The slinkies are not your friend. Why can't we get along? Holy crap. Y'all are evil, evil people. Why would you do this to Slinkies? Oh, hey, dude, the path went over there. Why are you being so mean? What? Why? Why? I'm going to the green path. The green path turned into the blue path. Really? Thanks for sharing. I'm in here picking on the dang robot. Somebody's probably upset. I like your robot. I like picking on robots. So when the robots take over the world, then I'll be the first one to go. Oh, this guy again. This should end well. Nope. Nope. Whoa, I was doing so well. Oh, nice. No, it's a beautiful game. It's, you know, definitely accomplished that. It's like, that's what drew me to the game is the art. The issue is it's so busy that it's hard to look at the art. Because you get distracted and then that happens. You just get to die. Awesome. See, but that, the stuff like that though, that's what makes these games that, right? Because it's the comic relief. It's, you know, if the player's already thinking about it and just being like, seriously, dude, you just told me the meteor shower's coming 15 times. Come on. You're killing me here. Kill me, Smalls. Even though it's my fault because I suck and I can't figure out how to get past the level. We gotta have somebody to take frustration out on, right? But whether I'm actually being able to play it or not, it's definitely... Really? I don't know what to tell you. He told me to go over there. The little things were there. I had to go. Oh, clipped it. Yeah, jerk slinkies. All right, guys. So I'm going to start probably shutting down here. But definitely, I want to thank the team from Dive Star Path and Gravity Well Studios for joining us. It's definitely a fun game. Definitely something I'm looking forward to seeing more of. And obviously, I can't hit freaking wow. Let's see. Is there another one? Nope. It's not letting me do it. Nope. I hit the wrong button. Let me try that one. Yes, let's do that one. So we're going to do one more here. And then we'll kind of see. This is it. This was his ship. Oh, no. But we're gonna, like I said, this is an awesome game. And it's coming out of University of Utah EAE program. So definitely go give those guys a little bit of love. Go let them know. Let them know that they're doing something good and that we can get people to come back. And thanks for the follow there, The Last Ginger. Oh, really? So y'all get the... Oh, that's not cool, yo. So there's EAE. So the Entertainment Arts and Engineering degree at the University of Utah. So here. So now you are making it where I have to try to go through and do all this stuff because now I'm going to feel bad if I don't make it. So yeah, but see, this is slower. It seems slower. Maybe I'm just smoking crack. So there's Danny. There's Kyle. So these are all the guys and gals that worked on the game. And like I said, I for one, I really appreciate the artwork. And, you know, let me have access to this thing to play it. Play it poorly, I might add. but thank you for letting me kind of hang out with you guys. But this honestly, I love this credits. This credits is awesome. That's something new because I haven't seen... Oh, well, here's just another level that you have to go play through the credits. You should give us some crazy thing like play through the credits for a Steam achievable. Like, I saved the credits. I don't think... Can I just fly through things? Music by Nick. I think I met Nick. Nick's cool. Voice talents. Oh, look at all the voice actors. Well, no, because that, you know, you were like, oh, yeah, because if not, somebody's going to come through here, right? And what they're going to do is they're going to be like, oh, well, you know, yeah, this is just a credits. I don't have to play this level because it doesn't look like Collision is on in this one. But definitely, you know, I would just, you know, if you play all the way to the end of the credits or you get X amount of something in here or something. That'd be cool. Return to fleet. But no, definitely awesome game. No, I'm impressed. You know, if y'all have time and y'all have the ability to, I'd definitely put stuff back in there, have us pick on the poor robot. Because that's just funny. If nothing else, will make you laugh while you're dying in space. Should anyone come along? Thank you for following my journey, wherever and whenever you may be. But definitely good stuff, guys. So I really appreciate y'all coming and hanging out with me tonight, kind of getting some more gameplay out there. We'll probably come back and revisit this one sometime in the future when I don't suck so bad. Secret passer on the asteroids. Yeah, there's all kinds of stuff in there. Like, it's, trust me, sitting back and watching this game is a lot easier than actually playing. Because you're saying it's just... Yeah, if the gravity and oxygen fishing don't get you, stream it and show us. No, yeah, definitely. It looks a lot easier to play than it really is. So, but with that, I'm going to go ahead and shut down for the night, guys. Definitely thank you for hanging out. Go check out Gravity Well Studios. This is the links to their Facebook and their their website. You can also follow them on Twitter. They have the at Dive Starpath for Twitter. You can come hang out with them. And also, like I said, if you are on Windows 10 and you're running on a real computer, there is a link. You can go download the game now. Get back to them. Let them know. It is a free game, so you can play it. You can do what you want to do. Get back in touch with them. Let them know. And I would go from there. And then definitely on your main screen here, I would put y'all's Facebook and your Twitter stuff, so that especially while people are, I'm running on a fake computer, but that way, because right now I have, you know, if somebody gets a hold of the game or something, they have no way to know who you guys are to get a hold of you. yeah, Chank's my Denmark guy. So yeah, there you go. So there's the Facebook and their Twitter. So go hang out with them, follow them, yell and scream at them, let them know what you liked, what you didn't like, give them feedback. But yeah, definitely thanks for hanging out, and definitely with that, I'm gonna be out, and then Wednesday night we'll be back for Operation Supply Drop. And I think Hep may actually join us this week and playing some Grand Theft Auto 5. So we're going to try to play some Grand Theft Auto 5 and do some of that stuff. Yep, and it is Steam Greenlight also. So I'll be in the chat for a little bit, but I'm going to go ahead and shut down the stream. So thanks for joining.